This is Clark Collis, EW Senior Writer, and today your guide to the Guardians of the Galaxy, well, galaxy, for lack of a better term. It's been 3 years since we last saw Star-Lord, Gamora, Drax, Rocket, and of course Groot, so we thought it was time to catch you up on the goings-on in the cosmic corner of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, as well as properly classify the new aliens, people, planets, and people planets populating Volume 2 in our Guardians of the Galaxy field guide. The sequel picks up with the Guardians enjoying a celebrity status of sorts in the wake of their galaxy-saving victory. However, an assignment goes sour due to rocket-related treachery, and this leads to a crash landing and quest by Star-Lord to find his real father, which brings us to the most anticipated new character, Ego, played by the inimitable Kurt Russell, who was not only Star-Lord, Peter Quill's father, he also happens to be a living planet. Whether he impregnated Star-Lord's human mother as a planet is yet to be known. Mantis, who is Ego's antennae-appendaged pet servant, joins the Guardian's quest and forms a common bond with Drax.
She just told everyone your deepest, darkest secret!
Meanwhile, the Guardians face off against intergalactic golden girl Aisha, leader of the Sovereign, an alien race attempting to make themselves flawless through genetic modification. No word on whether they reached this decision after binging the movie Gattaca. Aisha hires the Guardians to battle the tentacled, Cthulhu-like monster Abelisk. I'm not sure what's scarier, fighting this monster or simply trying to pronounce its name. Other new characters include Taserface, a mohawked villain played by This Is Us actor Chris Sullivan, and a mystery role filled by Michael Rosenbaum, who played Lex Luthor in Smallville. Speaking of mystery roles, Sylvester Stallone appears in the film as someone James Gunn describes as, quote, a very important part of the Marvel Cosmic Universe, unquote. My money's on Ego's tough-as-nails satellite moon, Tango. And lest you forget, all of this is building to Marvel's Infinity War series, which is expected to feature the Guardians and the Avengers facing off against Josh Brolin's character, Thanos, who also happens to be Gamora and Nebula's father. Yes, believe it or not, Marvel does plan to make more superhero movies. Another change worth mentioning for Volume 2, the character Groot is being replaced by Baby Groot.
I'm Groot.
No!
Which is a smaller version of the character from the original, voiced by Vin Diesel using a higher register.
I am Groot!
That's a really bad sign.
Now that should silence critics who've said Vin has no range. So, break your Walkman out of storage and start talking to your houseplants, because Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 is coming to this planet May 5th.